Hello, everyone. It is November 1st, and time for my October collection update video. As you can see here, it's a little bit of a different, you know, backdrop or base for the video. I wanted to try something else or something different because with my new apartment, the table that I used, there's only one spot in my apartment I could possibly use that table and have the room and not have there be a bunch of background noise, and that was moving it too, made it too complicated, so I wanted to try something else. Let me know in the comments if this is any better. If not, I'll go back to the table, whatever. But anyway, collection update. We have a little bit of everything except posters and wall scrolls. Again, more than I was expecting, but most of this stuff I actually got for free, because my birthday was actually this month. So a lot of this was for my birthday, or just random free stuff. There was a package video I made earlier this month, or earlier in October, that had a bunch of stuff for my girlfriend. That will be here. You'll get a better close-up of all of that. And then there's just other birthday stuff. So we'll start with DVDs and Blu-rays. Then CDs will actually be second for once, because of the video game stuff I got, kind of important, quite a bit of important stuff in there. So I wanted to actually do that last. But we'll go ahead and start with the movies and stuff. We'll start off with a Blu-ray I was actually supposed to get last month, but it was being borrowed at the time, and I didn't get it. But now I have it. I actually watched it. It's a good movie. That is Zootopia. Here we have it here. Really, really good movie. Surprised me actually how good it was. It's a really cute movie that actually has a lot of, like, it kind of mirrors the real world a little bit, let's just put it that way, without ruining too much. But it's basically a movie about a society of anthropomorphic animals, which is actually really cool. So, I really enjoyed this movie a lot. But yeah, really, really good, really, really good movie. Can't wait to watch it again. Then, the rest of this is all stuff that can kind of go together. I mean, these first two and then the last two, it's two pairs of things. I actually went to this, this store, this like used CD and DVD slash Blu-ray store where people sell their used stuff and, you know, you can buy it again. That I've actually gotten a lot of DVDs and some CDs from before. Usually about once a year I go out and spend a bunch of money there. But I was actually there just looking, and I ended up finding these. And these were about half the price that you would find them on eBay. So assuming they work, I actually got a really good steal here. Two Blu-rays. I got Iron Man 1 and Iron Man 2. I've actually seen these. I need to watch them again. You know, make sure everything works. Iron Man 2 is probably the weakest Marvel-made movie, to be completely honest. I still liked it a lot, but Iron Man is definitely much, much superior. And these are like special editions, basically, because this one's got 3 hours of bonus features, and this is the ultimate two-disc edition that has a bunch of stuff. So, yeah, I actually really like it. Robert Downey Jr. owns this role. Like, nobody else can ever play Iron Man in my book. But I'm actually trying to get every Marvel movie on Blu-ray or whatever. Pretty much Blu-ray, I think I've decided that. So, yeah, really happy to have this. Both really, really good movies. You know, I need to get the third one and a bunch of other ones. Plus, you know, he's in the new Spider-Man that's coming out, blah, blah, blah. You know, really good. Really cool to have this. It's awesome. Then we go on to close this section out. We go on to a show that I binge-watched with my girlfriend when I was in Virginia in September, and I already wanted to rewatch it because of the glory. It took me way too long to start watching this show because the most recent season was in 2015, and this show's been really, really popular for quite a while now. I just haven't watched it for some reason. And I watched my girlfriend, fell in love with it. I was actually able to find the two seasons on DVD on eBay for like $20 together, which is actually pretty impressive because usually new These were new. Usually new, that's about how much they are a piece. So I just said, screw it, and bought these. And that being Rick and Morty, this show, man, this show. Here you got both seasons. I just love grass tastes bad. It's a catchphrase. And Mr. Poopy Butthole. Yeah, this show. This show is amazing. It is the Adult Swim show now. If you're into shows like, I don't want to say if you're into shows like Family Guy and South Park, watch this. Because it feels a little bit more, it feels a lot more intelligent than, for sure, than Family Guy. I've always had a thing for South Park, just because I applaud shows that make fun of anything and everything, because that's how life should be. I mean, there are limits to what you should say, but you should be able to make fun of just about anything and everything. And this show doesn't push the boundaries quite that much, but it definitely does, and it definitely has a lot of pop culture references, and it's actually a really good show that'll actually make you feel if you watch it. So, you know, I definitely suggest this show to just about anyone. It's actually really, really good. I can't wait for season 3, which is supposed to come out sometime near next year. I don't know. But yeah, I absolutely love this show. Everybody should definitely check it out. So great. It has so many just like famous people that have been in this show. Like, the mother is Sarah Chalk from Scrubs. The dad is a dude from, I always forget his name, Chris Parnell, who was in Saturday Night Live. And then they've had like Keith David, Stephen Colbert, Patton Oswalt, David Cross, Key and Peele, Keegan-Michael Key and Jordan Peele, Tom Kenny, the voice of SpongeBob, Tara Strong, And then the same guy does the two main characters, which is hilarious. But this show is great. Definitely, definitely go check this out. It's such a great show. But that is it for DVDs and Blu-rays. We now go on to CDs. Now, there are 11 CDs this month, or 11 albums, let's put it that way. Of these 11, 3 of them I bought. The rest of them, and I will point them out, the rest of them I bought with a Amazon gift card that my father got me. My father got me a $100 Amazon gift card and told me to buy CDs, or said enjoy some CDs. So I told him I was only going to buy CDs, so I did. I probably could have bought more if I would have gone for the cheaper stuff, but I didn't. But that's okay. So we're actually going to start with a band. These two first CDs I actually paid for. I actually was at Goodwill with a friend of mine and found these two CDs for $2 a piece. And they're actually a band I've been meaning to check out. And then I come to find out that they're playing Wacken next year when I'm going. So, you know, it all kind of turned out for the best. And I don't know why they're opening this section, because they're probably the most popular band in this entire, of all these bands, but I'm starting with these. That is Lacuna Coil. I have two of their albums. We have Comalese Here, which is their third album, and Karma Code, which is their fourth album, I believe. These are probably their two most famous or critically acclaimed albums, this one being more popular. I'm actually going to have to say I enjoyed Comalese a little bit more. They were both good, but Comalese was pretty damn good. But Karma Code was still pretty good, but let's see, songs. Heaven's a Lie, Daylight Dancer, The Ghost Woman and the Hunter, Entwined, then Comalese, the title track was really good. This is actually a really good one. They're definitely symphonic metal. They're really good. Christina Scabbia is a really good singer, and I have, she's on an Arion album, which is really cool. I've been meaning to check these guys out. Let's see, this is Karma Code. Fragile, Our Truth, which is one of their more famous songs. Closer. And then Enjoy the Silence is a Depeche Mode cover, and it's actually really good. But yeah, I will definitely be buying more of these guys now that I know they're playing, you know, Atlanta.
I like how I just said a minute ago that they were playing Wacken in Germany when I see them, and then I turn around and do this. They are playing in Germany when I see them in August of 2017. Germany, 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 not Atlanta. I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry.
So, yeah, I gotta get more of them. So, you know, definitely cool to have these. I'm glad I finally checked them out because they're really good. I wouldn't say they're better than some of the bands I've heard, but still really, really good. And I'm glad to have it. Are they CD? Okay, then we go on to, well, some prog power bands, sort of, except two here. We start off with a band that's playing prog power this year, this next year, who was actually supposed to play in 2014, but when they all flew out, some stuff happened with other band members, so they weren't able to play. Thankfully, they were able to get them back so quickly. I actually have an album of this band that I really enjoyed. I was told to check this one out because it was also really good. That being Dynasty. I love how it's spelled. D-Y-N-A-Z-T-Y. This is their newest album, Titanic Mass. I have the one before this, Renatus, or Renatus, however you want to pronounce it. Both really good albums. I have to listen to Renatus again to determine which one I like more, but I love this heart-looking thing. Unfortunately, I guess in shipping, the case just kind of broke. But still, the CD works and everything, so it wasn't that big of a deal. It'll still work just fine. The Human Paradox, sorry for the light reflection, The Human Paradox is really good. Untamer of Your Soul, Roar of the Underdog, Titanic Mass, Keys to Paradise, I Want to Live Forever, Crack in the Shell, Free Man's Anthem. Yeah, there's some really, really good songs on here. These guys are really, 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 really good. I have to listen to Renatus again and get more of their stuff. I actually really, really like these guys. I'm probably not doing Prog Power next year, but still, might as well check these freaking guys out because it's really good. Good music, good solid heavy, like, I don't even know what, how you would, you know, classify these guys because they're not progressive and they're kind of power metal-y, I guess, is the best way to put them, but they're really, really good and I like them a lot. Definitely worth a check out. Then we go on to a band that I actually bought their first, not their first album, but my first album of theirs in Atlanta last month. I really liked that album, and I deliberately went out and bought myself their first album at the beginning of the month. That being Andromeda. This is their very first album and probably their most popular, Extension of the Wish. This is actually the re-release of the first album with their, like, their official singer. Because when they first recorded this album, it was with basically a guest singer. And then basically every other album has had the same singer, or a different singer, like their official singer. And this is a re-recording they did in 2004 with him, so he sings it, the whole thing. I probably could have gotten the original version, but I just felt like buying this one because, why not? I actually think it's harder to find, actually. I was able to find it on eBay for really cheap, so I bought it. But then with my dad's gift card, I actually bought another one of theirs. This is their second to most recent album, The Immunity Zone. I actually am gonna have to say that as a whole, this might be their best album. I did really like Manifest Tyranny. This one was all right. We'll actually start with the newer one. Slaves of the Plethora Season was good. Censoring Truth, Worst Enemy. And then Veil of Illumination is 17 minutes and 26 seconds long. But pretty good CD. Wasn't quite as good as even Manifest Tyranny. But this one is completely different because with Immunity Zone and Manifest Tyranny, it feels like they're really politically charged. This one is just them having fun, and it's really melodic and really, really good. Words Unspoken, Crescendo of Thoughts is good. Funny thing here about track number 4. It says Starshotter Supreme. It's supposed to be Starshooter, and this version this final extension version, that's a typo on every copy. And then you got Chameleon Carnival, which is a really good instrumental and spelled, you know, Carnival, Extension of the Wish. Clips is good too. These are actually two bonus tracks, technically, if I remember right. But still, really, really good album. I believe I'm only missing two more of these guys' albums, so I will be picking them up eventually. But still, really, really cool to have these guys. Definitely some good prog metal. They played prog power before too. Then we go on to a band that is... I hadn't really heard of them before, but their singer's pretty famous now, sort of. And they're basically the halfway slot on one of the days at Prog Power next year. I can't remember if it's Friday or Saturday. But that band is Lords of Black. This is their newest album, their second album, just titled 2. Their singer is Ronnie Romero, who was handpicked by Richie Blackmore from Rainbow to sing for Rainbow for their reunion tour. So that's really cool. This is his power metal band. This is his band, Lords of Black. I bought the CD. At first, the first like song disappointed me, but then it started kicking my butt. So this is a really, really good album. But we'll start, what songs? We got Merciless, Everything You're Not, New World's Coming, Cry No More, Live by the Lie, Die by the Truth. And this is the Art Illusion, the Art of Illusions Part 3, The Wasteland, that's, you know, Parts 1 and 2 are on their first album. And this is actually a cover of Rainbow, Lady of the Lake, so that's pretty funny. But really good album. I'm going to buy their first one, because there's only one more. So, you know, there's that. Really happy to have this. It's really, really good. Straight up power metal, some good solid stuff. Then we go on to the final CD of a band, of their discography that I needed, that I basically got the majority of last month. And this is a band that's also was supposed to play Prog Power, but had to cancel because of band stuff. That being Anubis Gate, this is the only album I had left. Their self-titled album, Anubis Gate, just Anubis Gate, self-titled. I love the little sketch drawing of the eye there. This is literally the only album I had left, because I got all the hard-to-get ones last month with the Orbitz box set, and I figured, why not? Let's just get this one. Actually, most of these, now that I think about it, I spun a wheel. That's right. Only three of these albums I bought willingly, like I picked out when I had the gift card. The rest of them I put a bunch of CDs on a wheel and just spun the wheel. So most of the stuff you've seen on here, you see on here, is from that wheel. So Lords of Black, Anubis Gate, the second Andromeda, the Immunity Zone, and Dynasty were all spun off the wheel. And the second to last CD you'll see here, and then some that I'll talk about in a minute. But Anubis Gate, really happy to have this. It was definitely really good. I liked it a lot. I still need to listen to Horizons again, but Hold Back Tomorrow, Reformation Show, World in a Dome, Golden Days, yeah, Telltale Eyes, really, really good. Their newest, most recent singer is really good. I like him a lot. But glad to finally have these guys' discography finished. I mean, I guess they're working on a new album, but hey, I'm glad I have the whole thing finished. It's really good to have it finished. But definitely some good progressive power metal. Definitely good. They're more progressive now. I would suggest their more recent stuff, definitely. But yeah, Anubis Gate. Then we go on to one of my favorite bands. Technically, I have their entire discography finished, but there were two extra CDs I wanted to get, and they're both acoustic, and I've been meaning to get them for a while, and I finally found the reason to with my dad's gift card. That being Pain of Salvation. This is their acoustic album, Falling Home. They released this last year, 2 years ago. They released it right after Prog Power, the year I saw them. I still don't understand this cover. It's all of the band carrying a coffin, and then their keyboardist carrying a desk chair, like an office chair. But it's an acoustic album. This is actually the special edition, I found out. because it's, well, technically it's got two sides like a vinyl, but it's just acoustic versions of a lot of their songs, some covers, and then a new song, which is the last one. But like they got Stress, which is off of Entropia, Linoleum, which is off of Road Salt 1, To the Shoreline, which is Road Salt 2, a cover of Holy Diver by Dio, which is like this smooth jazz cover, which is really weird. 1979, which is off Road Salt 2. She Likes to Hide might be off Road Salt 1, I can't remember exactly. Chainsling, which is off of my favorite album of all time, Remedy Lane. And then a cover of Lou Reed, Perfect Day. I always wondered what this song was, and then I heard it, and I've actually heard this song quite a lot. And it's not even Lou Reed's most famous song, which is weird, because I've heard that, and yeah. And then the next three songs, Spitfall, Miss Modern Mother Mary, and Flames of the Moth, are from Scarsick. Spitfall is this weird rap song, weird rap thing, so it's weird to hear it acoustically. And then you got, and actually, now that I think about it, She Likes to Hide is a bonus track, and then King of Loss here is the other bonus track. Longest song on the album, but it's off of Perfect Element, Part 1. And then the only original song from this album, or the only new song, Falling Home, which is actually a really good song. But I really like this CD. It's a really beautiful acoustic, you know, version or acoustic retelling of their songs. But then I went and got this, their acoustic live album. This is, I don't really know how to pronounce it. I always call it 12 to 5. Or it's actually, I believe it was recorded on the 12th of May. And in Europe, they do dates like that. So I think that's actually what it's called. But this is actually before half of their any of their members left. But this is an acoustic live show. The three books, Genesis, Genesis Sister, and Genesis Sinister. It's basically just acoustic retellings of their songs up to this point, which is right before Scarsick, I believe. This was right after, I believe this was recorded in 2004. Just, I'm going through the book because I want to, like, book one, Genesis, has, I believe this is, it doesn't actually tell me. But it's basically just passages from a lot of their songs, and then there's some full songs, and then more passages, and then just, like, some instrumental stuff. But it's really, really good. I actually really enjoyed this, too. I'm really glad to have both of these, actually. I was really happy to have them both. Really, really good. I love Pain of Salvation. They have a new album coming out January 17th, I think is what it was. So, yeah, really happy to have this. All right, moving on to the last Wheel Spun one of this month. That being a band that is headlined Prog Power, we got Epica. This is their new album, The Holographic Principle. I really liked the first album of theirs I got, Requiem for the Indifferent. I got that on my own, and then at Prog Power in 2014, I got Quantum Enigma. And then I got this month, just by chance, because it spun off a wheel. I really, really like Simone Simmons, the female vocalist. I really like her singing style. But dude, Death Growls, there's the Death Growls, and it's okay, but it just kind of kills it for me. Sometimes. I really do like Epica. I like her singing, and the music is really good. They're getting really, really, orchestrated. So they're getting, up orchestrated with, Nightwish and stuff. It's getting pretty nuts. But let's see, Edge of the Blade is good, The Phantasmic Parade, Universal Death Squad, Beyond the Matrix, Once Upon a Nightmare, Dancing in a Hurricane, and then I believe The Holographic Principle I really like too, which is 11 and a half minutes long. But yeah, I really like these guys. Definitely worth a check out if you're into the stuff like that. I will buy more of their stuff. The rest of their stuff is like earlier stuff, so it's going to be fun to get. But yeah, so really cool to have. Happy to have it. Epica, yeah. Then we go on to, well, something a little bit special, I guess, sort of. A band that would definitely headline Prog Power if they were to ever play, but dude doesn't tour. This is Arion. I finally got another album of theirs, well, two, technically. This is the Universal Migrator Parts 1 and 2. This is the special edition. This is the re-release of both parts. because originally this was split into two different CDs, and this is technically two CDs, but it was released separately, the two CDs. And then this is the re-release from 2004. Yeah. The only reason I got this version is because when I checked to see how much both albums were, it came out to be way too expensive, so I just bought them together. And I mean, it's an official release, so I guess I can deal with this. But it's basically two discs. They'll come out. I actually just listened to this one today. The rest of them I have listened to. I listened to a while ago. But I realized I was running a little bit behind. But basically, this is two different contrasting albums. Kind of like The Gentle Storm, with one being a little bit softer and the other one being a little bit heavier. But this first disc here, this is Universal Migrator Part 1, The Dream Sequencer. See, this is more of a prog rock album. And there's people like the singer for Tiamat on that one. It's got Neil Morse from Spock's Beard on it. And it's got Damian Wilson, who was in Threshold, which is a really big progressive metal band. But really cool to have. This is a good one. I was a little disappointed by a lot of this one. Actually, this whole album didn't impress me too incredibly much. I still think everything Human Equation Onward is really, really good. I'll have to listen to 01 and Theory Everything again, because Human Equation is a masterpiece. But the second disc, this is Part 2, Flight of the Migrator. I can say I like this one more because it was a lot heavier, and it has like Russell Allen from Symphony X. It has a guitar solo by Ryko Romeo from Symphony X, a guitar solo by one of the guitarists for Shadow Gallery. It's got the lead singer from Rhapsody, Primal Fear, Stradivarius, Helloween, and then frickin' Bruce Dickinson from Iron Maiden. But I did like disc 2 a lot better, but overall, I mean, it was all right. The story is too complicated and it's too sci-fi for me. So, you know, it was still a really good album. It was better than The Final Experiment and Actual Fantasy, I can say that. I have one album of these guys left that's Into the Electric Castle, and I'm going to have to buy it on eBay because for some reason it got really expensive on Amazon. So I will buy that. I'm hoping to buy it next month, actually. And actually, there's going to be a new album coming out, and he's slowly releasing the singers and instrumentalists. So far, he's actually announced James LaBrie from Dream Theater again, who did The Human Equation, which is awesome. The lead singer of Between the Buried and Me is going to be in the new one. Mike Mills, who was in The Theory of Everything and did Theater Equation. And then Simone Simmons from Epica, who did one song on 01. She's going to be playing a bigger role. And then, what's the dude's name from Mr. Big and stuff? I can't remember his name.
It's Paul Gilbert. I can't believe I forgot that.
And then today he just did a reveal of another singer. He hasn't revealed who it is, but a lot of people are saying it's either Flora Jansen or Irene Jansen. Flora Jansen was in Into the Electric Castle? No, she was in this one. That's right, she is in this one, sorry. She's in this one and 01, so it's either her or Irene Jansen who was in The Human Equation, their sisters, so it could be either of them.
It is Flora Jansen, so that would make this her third appearance in an Arion album. I believe that's actually more than anyone else.
But really happy to have this. Arion is amazing. It's just a bunch of singers from different popular bands, so it's really, really good. Popular prog or power metal bands. Okay, that is it for CDs. We move on to the final section, video games. And this is an interesting section because it's got a giant mess of stuff. We'll start off with my birthday presents. First of all, on Steam, my friend Philly and his family got me Dark Souls 2, Scholar of the First Sin. I already had Dark Souls 2, the original one, but all my friends were like, Scholar of the First Sin is way better. It's all the DLC, even though I have all the DLC in Dark Souls 2, but it's like, if you want to play with us, you got to have this version, and it's easier and better and blah, blah, blah. So it's just like, okay, whatever. And I didn't have to pay for it because I got it for my birthday. So I'm really happy to have it. I can actually try to connect with my friend Brandon now, because when we tried to do it in Dark Souls 1, we sat there for like 2 hours and we got nowhere. It was actually pretty funny. But yeah, really happy to have that game. So excited to die 100 million times. Then we go on to two troll gifts that my friends got me. My friend Phoenix and his girlfriend Monica, who's also a friend. I don't know why I separated that. But she got me, actually, we'll start with his. Let's just start with his. He got me a PS3 game. This is a fun wrestling game called Lucha Libre Heroes del Ring, or Eros del Ring. I don't remember how to pronounce it. It's basically based on AAA, which is Japanese, or a Mexican or Hispanic wrestling company. Can't remember how it's pronounced or what it stands for, but there's a bunch of wrestlers I've actually heard of in here. The controls are terrible. It's not as bad as WCW Mayhem, but it's still really bad. According to my friend Phoenix, he's getting me a serious gift. He just has yet to do that. But hey, you know what? Free game. I'm not going to argue. And then there's this. You know, and I don't know what to say about this. It's a DS game. This is Drama Queens, a board game where you model and find a boyfriend and friends and get a job. You know, there's really not much to say about that. So, moving on. My girlfriend sent me a package, if you've seen the video. And she sent me some really, really cool stuff. We'll start off with the giant chunk of stuff that really goes together. First of all, she gave me one of these. We'll zoom out a little bit. This in the packet. We have a lime green Game Boy Color. Unfortunately, it doesn't have battery casing, but still, lime green Game Boy Color, that's awesome. It also came with a nice lime green neck lanyard thing to put it in, which is pretty funny. It does work. I believe I put batteries in this Game Boy, and it does work. So it's really cool to have this, another Game Boy Color. But she actually gave me some games as well, which is awesome, because, you know, last month I came back with Game Boy games, now I'm coming back with Game Boy Color games. We'll go through here. First off, we got the Rugrats movie. Unfortunately, this game doesn't actually work. It's the only one I could not get to work, which sucks, because I want to see how they would do a Rugrats game on the Game Boy. Sad, but it doesn't work, unfortunately. Then we have Tom and Jerry. I can't even remember half of these games. I wish I had remembered most of these. I think this is a platformer of some sort. It was kind of cheesy, but, you know, whatever. And then another Tom and Jerry. We have Tom and Jerry Mouse Hunt, which obviously I want to think, from what I remember, it was kind of like a Find Jerry kind of thing. Still, Game Boy, early Game Boy game, not that great, but whatever, free game. Hey, not going to argue, it's Tom and Jerry. My girlfriend loves Tom and Jerry. There is nothing wrong with Tom and Jerry. Then we have, this is Shrek Fairy Tale Freakdown. I can't even remember what this game was. I just can't. I think I repressed most of these or something. But it's a Shrek game. Oh boy. Shrek is love, Shrek is life. Then we have Beauty and the Beast, a board game adventure. It's a board game about Beauty and the Beast. Not much to say. I don't know how you would do that, but I'm not going to talk about it. Then a game that I actually am really happy to have, because I have actually wanted this game, even though I technically have it on the NES. This is Super Mario Bros. Deluxe, which is basically Mario Brothers, Super Mario Brothers, the original, on Game Boy Color. Still really cool to have, because, you know, why not? You know, it's cool. Really happy to have this Mario Deluxe, yeah. Then she actually gave me something really cool, and I'm actually going to set this up. This is called a Shock Jock. In the video, I couldn't figure out what this was for. This is the power cable to it. But I can actually show you guys now. So what you are about to see here is me attempting to show you guys how to use this shock jock thing. Now, I have some issues with it in the video here because the plug for it, the power plug, is one of the weirdest shapes I've ever seen. It's a big block, but instead of like the prongs being at the top, it's right in the middle. So you have to have like a whole big space for it to plug it in. And I didn't have that because I have a power strip plugged into that same power outlet that my router is plugged into, and I couldn't unplug that because that's my internet, and that would cause
a whole load of problems. So there's some technical difficulties here, but overall, I think you'll get the point of what this thing does.
So basically, you plug in the jack here, and what you do is you grab your Game Boy. This is mine because I feel like it fits this better because it's the right color. What you do, and we're going to do some Pokemon Crystal, you take the batteries out, and then you just kind of, you set it in there, and then you slide this thing up to basically lock it in place, or not. Yeah, you basically lock it in place, and then you hit the on button on the thing, and you hit the on button on the Game Boy, and you turn the volume up, maybe. Huh. I appear to have turned it off on accident. This was not this difficult the first time I did it. Holy crap. What's going on? There we go. There it is. It's basically a giant vibration pack. Oh, it's really loose. Yeah, it's a giant vibration pack. Okay, here. Let's... I didn't have this many issues with it before, but it's a giant vibration and sound pack, so it basically amplifies the speakers, so you can hear it a lot better, and it vibrates. But it's really cool, you know? And it vibrates, you can hear it. It's really cool. Really cool to actually have this. This is a nice, really cool accessory to have for the Game Boy Color. Alright, then we go on to more special stuff for this video game section. We start with something my coworker actually bought me near the coast, and I decided I'm just gonna keep this and put this on my shelf. It is Nintendo Power Mints in a tin shaped like an NES controller. They're still in here, it's sealed, I'm not gonna open it. I just thought it was something I could show in this video, why not? Because it's kinda cool, I like that. Then we have something special. You probably can't tell what this is, but I got it from GameStop because I asked them for it. Now we're going to turn it on. We're going to turn it on. We're going to turn it on.
Stop! Welcome to Suplex City.
Yeah, it's Paul Heyman. But basically what this is a motion sensor that I still have yet to figure out quite how it works. But basically it was sitting in a little box that hung from the ceiling, and I noticed it did that. And, yeah, it was really cool, and I asked for it, and they gave it to me. I kind of want to put it up on my wall. I'm still trying to figure out where the sensor is. Like, I wonder if I broke it or something.
No place on Earth is as dangerous as Suplex City.
I made it work, but I guess there's a time limit or something. We'll turn it off, but it's a nice little cool thing to have. I'm probably going to put this in a box or something, I don't know. But it was still something kind of random and pretty cool to get. Then we go back to more stuff my girlfriend got me. Two more things. This is something I might end up using. It's a nice either faux leather or leather case for the Game Boy Advance SP. You can put stuff in here. It's really cool. I might actually start using this. But really cool to have this because it's a nice carrying case as opposed to nothing. Then something special that I don't know if it works. Crystal said she couldn't get it to work, but I'm smart and I'm sure I could probably get this to work. It is an e-reader back from the Game Boy Advance era where you slid cards and stuff. I just want to try it with like the Pokemon games and stuff. I'm hoping it works. I do need to get an original Game Boy Advance for this to work though. It does not work on the SP, but really happy, really, really happy to have this because I've always wanted one of these. Then to finish out this section, I had a little bit of extra money, so I thought, why not buy some of these, because I've been wanting to get these series since they came out, being Amiibo. I got three of them, let's just drop them, that's a great idea. I got Waddle Dee, we'll zoom out, from the Kirby set, we got Waddle Dee, King Dedede, and Meta Knight. Unfortunately, the GameStop did not have Kirby, so I got three of the four. I actually bought DDD first and then these two at a later date. So we'll go ahead and show you them close up. There's Waddle Dee. They actually look, at least Waddle Dee looks really good. And then DDD looks okay. His face looks kind of ridiculous. He looks pretty good though. I like how he looks. And then Meta Knight actually looks really good. I think they actually increased the quality of these things quite a bit. But really happy to have these. I haven't gotten Amiibo in a while. You know, I just kind of got them spur of the moment. Really cool to have them, you know. It's really cool. I just need to find Kirby. I've been meaning to get these guys for months. And I did. So, you know, really good. Really cool. But that is it for my collection update. I will definitely see you guys next month. Oh, one last thing. I got a new phone. It's an S7 Edge. This phone is a boss. Just got it today. So, that being said, that's the end of this video. I will be back next month because there are still two CDs from the gift card that I haven't gotten yet. One of them was supposed to come with Epica from Britain, but only one showed up. So I'm going to have to message them and find out if they just forgot or if it's coming or what. And then the other CD just I ordered later on my own. That's right, I paid for that one on my own, and it'll be here. And then I'm going to try to get into the Electric Castle. There's some pre-orders I have paid off that are coming out, so they'll at least be those. They'll at least be the pre-orders and the CDs that I still need to get. Otherwise, I do kind of need to tone down how much I spend. I say that every month, but it doesn't end up happening, which is terrible. I'm a terrible example. But that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Yeah, I'll see you next month. Later. Ooh. Timber. Later.